What role do you see London Business School and the Global Energy Summit playing in the energy debate? And how can the school contribute to address challenges in the energy sector?
I think business schools quite rightly focus on imagined expertise and other expertise that has already been known and researched about. What I think they need to do in addition is consider what others have not considered. Where are world leaders looking in the wrong direction? You need to challenge. You need to take the debate to the public and say, hold on, are they doing these things the right way, or are there other things we should be doing instead? A radical change of view is what I think academic institutions can offer, both on the world stage and also corporates.
And you did a great job of challenging the room today. In the near future, what other topics do you see playing high on the minds of our industry's executives?
I think the debate today has focused quite considerably on the supply of energy, in whatever form it might be, nuclear or renewables or oil and gas. But if we want to get a grip of greenhouse gas emissions, we have to consider the supply side and the demand side. And there's a lot of focus on the supply side. A lot of money is being committed over the next 15 years to trying to make our supply side more efficient. But in truth, if you can persuade people to reduce the amount of energy they use, then you're talking to the whole globe of 6 billion people, of whom probably 500 million or a billion people are the ones who truly use most of the energy on our planet. Reaching them with and trying to change their attitudes towards energy is probably an even more effective way of saving the planet, reducing greenhouse gas emissions.